Hey guys, welcome to day one of your upgrade your backhand challenge. This is a one-handed series, and today I've got an awesome video for you because we're going to clone Mr. Perfect, Roger Federer's one-hand topspin backhand. I'm going to show you everything you need to know. Every nook and cranny of Roger Federer's backhand is going to be covered today. This is something that you can do whether you are in your living room, in your driveway, on the court like I am today, and you're going to study and watch each and every move so you can develop one of the most beautiful backhands in the history of tennis. And today's challenge, I actually got something really cool that I'm gonna give you. You see, one of the things that's important is get the right grip. So I've got this Grip Right trainer from my buddies at On Court, Off Court. I actually have an extra one in my pocket. Let me see if I can get it. Yeah, so in a raffle, if you just like comment what you're looking most forward to, you can comment by audio, by video, or just in the written text, what you're looking most forward to in this 7-day upgrade your backhand challenge, I'll put you in a raffle to win this, plus I'm gonna send you Roger Federer's book, okay? Because I figure, hey, we gotta start with Mr. Perfect. All right, let's get started, okay? There's many, many things that we wanna do to get that Roger Federer backhand. I'm gonna cover each and everything. The first thing is the grip. Notice how I put this knob on the top of the racket, and what I love about this is how it makes my hand shape. Do you see? And that's one of the things I notice about Roger Federer's backhand, which I will show you, is how relaxed his hands are and how his fingers are separated. And this Grip Right trainer, it gives you that look automatically, where lots of people, what they do is they tend to hold their hands too close together, too tight. You see, there's no space. You want to definitely space out. This is important, and this grip changer trainer has you do that. But even if you don't have it, this is what you want. And notice how I put this angled right on the top of the racket here, okay? So this bevel right here, if you take a look at it, can you see it? I want to make sure you can see that nice and clear, and I just put that right there. So I'm in my motorcycle grip, and this is super important. So that's one thing I want you to think about. And then as you're doing it, make sure that you're nice and relaxed, that you're not death gripping the racket. This is actually one of the things that I have to work on the backhand. I was really studying Roger Federer's backhand over and over and over again from each and every angle before I came out here to give you this lesson. And I start to notice some things that I'm like, oh yes, these are things we want to pick up. The first thing I notice is just his ready position. I noticed that when he's rallying, he's got his hand, his dominant hand low around his waist, okay? His non-dominant hand has the racket tilting up and off to the backhand side. So even as he's rallying, he's in this position. His hands are nice and relaxed by his side. You can see the elbows on either side of his body. So even though he's got this wide base in his legs have a very wide base, but those hands, the elbows are coming outside. You can see them clearly, so he doesn't have them in here. He's got them out here where you can see those elbows, and the racket face is tilting up already. This is super important because I'm gonna show you some of the things that I see a lot of people on the recreational courts doing on their backhand, and this little subtle difference is gonna make a big difference in your flow, okay? Which is what I really, when I'm watching Roger Federer's backhand, I'm thinking it flows so beautifully. So he's here, and then the other thing I want you to realize, he's always in this light, airy, bouncy shuffle, especially on the practice court. He's just so light and airy with his feet, and he's always got a nice, wide base split step. And so this is something that a lot of people overlook. And most people, when I give them their first lesson, you know, they get in a plane, they fly out from California to come see me, and I'll say, are you ready? And I go to feed them a ball, and they're like, I'm ready, coach. Do you see what's wrong with this picture? Okay? I'm guaranteeing you, if I ask Rafael Nadal, if I ask Roger Federer, are you ready to play? They're gonna go, oh yeah, let's start playing. Okay, I'm ready to play. So that's one thing I notice in all the videos is Roger Federer has this nice, light, airy bounce, and he's got this ready position like this. And then as the ball comes, the first move is so important. Most people, their first move is, again, their hands are all tight, and they start bringing the racket back in this position for the one-handed backhand, and then they go and they muscle through the shot, right? So lots of people are out here, here. What Roger Federer starts to do is, as he sees the ball, see, again, notice how I'm turning too right away. That's another big thing. People are turning, getting this hip stuck. Roger Federer does not do that. I notice he's got it, especially when you watch it in slow motion, he's got a gradual turn. So as he sees the ball come, he starts bringing his hands up and relaxed right away. So his first move, notice how I'm transferring, we'll get the back camera to get this. I'm transferring to this back leg, so I'm opening up, I'm not closing up. So Roger Federer is gonna open up, even if he can't open up, even if he's gotta step back before the ball comes, I notice he starts to at least put the weight on the back leg again before he comes in. Where one of the biggest power killers on the backhand is people get into hip lock. They turn and they turn and they get set here and they're waiting on the ball, and then all they can do is power through it. So Roger Federer's always gonna be making a nice dance from the back leg into the front leg. It's gonna look very, very pretty. So his first move, he sees the ball coming. It's a gradual turn. He starts bringing his racket head up. So as it's turned to the side, it's about this high, okay? And then he keeps bringing it up where the racket is actually just above the top of his head, so he gets to about this high. Now, as we get through the week, I'm just showing you what Roger Federer does. I'm gonna recommend that some of you don't go that high. That might be a little too much, and I'll explain why towards the end of this video, why we might not wanna go there just yet. But at least we can start to see, because some of you, this is gonna click right away. Others, this is gonna be a little too tough to do when you start playing. In theory, it sounds great and it looks beautiful, but it might be a little too much for some of you. But he comes up here, and then he drops into the slot to where now you notice the strings are actually facing towards the back fence. Which is the completely different than our Upgrade Your Forehand Challenge. Notice how all the coaching has been, it's a big no-no to bring the racket on the opposite side of your body and to get your wrist, your racket lag pointing out to the side. Okay, this is a big no-no. They'd say, well, that's not an ATP forehand, right? We're taught, you gotta come here, out to the side, you gotta pat the dog. This is what we all covered in the ATP forehand, right? And then you get that wrist lag, that snap, the lag and snap, you come back here, you show the butt to the ball, and you go. Well, showing the butt of your tennis racket to the tennis ball on a backhand is actually a backhand power killer, see? So if I get set, and I'm showing the racket butt, if I only get to show the racket butt to the tennis ball, I'm leaving a lot of power and spin on the table. This turns into more of a push. So the racket lag on a one-handed backhand is actually getting the strings to face to the back fence here and holding on the racket to where your racket butt is jutting out to the side fence. So that you'll notice that's what Roger Federer's doing. He's nice and relaxed, he's moving up, he starts to drop into the slot, and then as he gets in the slot, this is where he starts to step into the ball, and he keeps coming under the ball in a nice relaxed fashion, hits and comes through. And we'll talk a little bit more about the end here in a second. But one of the things that you can actually do, and if you're at home right now through these crazy times we're in, you can actually use your topspin trainer, or just put like a towel in front of you right here and imagine a ball coming. I would do that before you even worry about hitting a ball, and see if you could put your racket here and just see if you can grab the racket, drop, and then come up and hit. Because what a lot of people do on their one-hander, one of the biggest things that people have trouble with is they can't get under the ball. So in order to get under the ball, since they kind of get locked around here, like their wrist just will not relax, their arm will not keep dropping and flowing, you're holding on the racket too tight. Roger Federer's loose and relaxed and letting the momentum of the stroke work the whole way. So he's got a beautiful drop below the ball and then up and through, as you'll see in some of these videos we're doing to support this, where you're getting here, and then to still get under the ball, you start to come at the ball like this. You see how that racket face is open, and then you hit, and then you keep going like that, and then a lot of people end up going like this on their one-hander, and that's why you can't really get the spin that you want. I think for most people, the one-hander is the biggest challenge of feeling what spin feels like, and it's that you're not dropping into this lag position, and then even from here, continuing to relax. So if you just hold it back here, and then you've got to find it, especially if you got your grip trainer, it makes it even easier. Then you got to find it, continue to relax and drop and come on up and hit. And you see how that this ball is spinning, you see? Super important. We'll show you that from the side. So this is a super important concept. So I want to show you this from the side. So again, everything we've covered so far is we're here. We're down here, we get this split step, and in a very relaxed manner, as we're turning here, it's a gradual turn, and instead of getting right here side on, so we're rising here, and then we get up to a little bit over our head, and then it's got to drop back here. We got to get to this position where now the racket butt is facing out to the fence, and then we got to keep relaxing under the ball to come up. If we don't do that, if the racket doesn't continue to relax, if you don't let your body continue to flow, pretend you're like a tire and you got to come all the way under and then back up like this to hit the ball and to get that spin, where most people get kind of here, kind of very rigid. And so you get here, then maybe you get here, and now all of a sudden your hand locks up, and then you got to come like that to the ball, where Roger Federer is here, comes above his head, he continues to drop in a relaxed fashion, and boom. So again, just practicing being right here and seeing that, having to grab, drop, up and hit. And just practice it over and over again, getting here, getting comfortable grabbing, continue to relax, drop, up and through. Okay? Very, very important. Now, another thing that is super important is that you're relaxed, you're flowing, and you're committed to stepping in. Because I think what people tend to do is, you know, it's like anything. We have, there's the procrastination factor on a backhand is bigger than any other stroke I see out there, to where you just procrastinate. You're just afraid that the backhand, so you wait to step, you have a very meager step. By the time you're hitting, you're behind. You see that? And on any backhand you're behind, you're gonna have a heck of a time hitting the backhand. You literally can't make it. Where look, if I'm a little behind on a two-hander, you see that, I can still make that. On a one-hander, I can't get my racket around. So you notice when Roger Federer steps, he's got a healthy step into the ball, and he's hitting that ball even out in front of his foot or just about where his foot is. Either of those will do. So lots of times on video, you're gonna see him out here, way out in front of his foot on contact, or right even with his foot. But once that ball moves past your foot, you're in trouble. You can't get around that ball. So then again, you can't get the top spin that you're looking for. So super important there. So make sure, as you notice, Roger Federer here, he's got a nice, healthy, relaxed stride into the ball. So again, it's great to have, now that we have this time with everything that's going on, it's great to have a towel here. You don't need the Topspin Pro. I love the Topspin Pro, but you can put a towel there as your contact point and get used to practicing, getting out the timing of your steps that you're gonna take a nice healthy step into the ball and hit out in front of your foot, okay? That's super important, because if you mistime those steps and you go to step and now you're even, look how you're jammed. You see that? And this is probably the biggest thing that makes it so hard to get topspin. See, I can't even put really good topspin on this because I'm too close to it, where again, in close quarters, I can get away with this on a two-hander. Look how that ball's rolling. I can get away with this on a forehand being this close. On a one-handed backhand, I can't get away with it. Okay, so we need this nice, healthy stride up into the ball to get our topspin. The next thing that we want to do to clone Roger Federer's backhand, now that we've got this step, this contact point out here, is the ending is super important. Roger Federer is doing a gradual upward and out swing, where lots of people on a one-hander, they stop abruptly, they stop here because they're afraid to hit it, or they start opening their shoulders too early, especially sometimes I think trying to copy Stan Wawrinka might get you in trouble, because you see how Stan, he opens up his chest a little more than Federer does, but if you watch him in slow motion, he's still coming out through the ball and then doing that. But it's so important that when you're doing this, is that you're going under, upward, and out, that you go out as far as you can, and then you can start coming around. And that's what Roger Federer is doing, okay? Which is super, super important to copy, is that you're getting this length, that you're just not brushing up the ball. You gotta be brushing up the ball and out through it, and it's a gradual thing. It's basically coming under, hitting, and the whole time it's moving out and up, and then it's coming over. And then you want your hand to relax at the end. And a magic trick, we'll put like a red ribbon on this. Notice how in the beginning, this is on the top, and then it's gonna end on the bottom. They're gonna flip. The top becomes the bottom, and this is how you, again, get some extra spin, and we notice that that's what Roger Federer is doing, where many players like John McEnroe, he didn't flip over. He came here and he pushed out, and the top stayed the top. And many players out there having the top stay the top, and again, it's hard to get topspin. You can get a nice little push shot. You can push through the ball, but when you want to stroke through the ball, we need, again, by the time we're done, see? The top becomes the bottom. See that? And the final thing, the thing that Roger Federer does, that even as I'm watching, I'm going, I've got to do better at that. And I'm going to show the side camera from two different angles, because this is so important that you want to practice over and over again, is that Roger Federer, when he's done, that he is very disciplined with his non-dominant hand. And a lot of people, as soon as you start to go and you focus on the ball, you completely forget about this hand. Same thing on the forehand. It's probably the biggest thing that people need to work on. Where they're serving, they're very weak with this hand. Where they're setting up, they're very weak with this hand. And certainly on the one-hander, you get ready, you're focused on that ball, you let go of the racket, all of a sudden you completely forget about this, you're hitting, and it can be the reason why you're opening up too early. Roger Federer is very good at what I call the Fed puff. He really, like Superman, he's puffing his chest to the world, and it's usually to the side fence for an awful long time, and then he's done. So again, watch how disciplined, if I'm trying to pretend that I am Roger Federer here, I'm getting here, I'm rising up, I'm coming behind the head, I'm dropping, I'm coming through, and I've got this counterbalance, and I want to be loose. It's very easy to kind of tighten up back here and tighten up in the hands, but he's also, his arm, he looks loose doing it. So try and be relaxed, something I've got to work on. And you see that Fed puff, see how my chest is facing out here, see how far I've come around, and you really see that. Lots of times you'll see his arms almost like they can, so flexible and relaxed with it, looks like they can almost reach back and touch each other. It's quite a beautiful thing to do. And to watch, I mean, and if you can do it, it's gonna make your backhand really good. It's, why is he doing that? Why do one-handers do that who have really great one-handers? Why do we see that over and over again? And probably most pronounced by Federer is because if you don't do that, there's a tendency to come around. Like if you're at your clubs, have you seen people like, they're out there going like that. They're going, right? You can see that doesn't look near as pretty. And so this offhand is helping you go through it, reach out to the target, really get everything going forward with your spin instead of just coming around. Now the ball could just tend to fly on you. You have no control. You have no idea where it's going. So again, right here, setting, boom. And then one thing I want you to notice about this finish is look how the toe is also pointing here, right? I've got this toe just dragging. So I want you to focus on that. That's one of the things that Rick Macy actually had me do when I was hitting my forehand. He said I was coming around too soon and to drag my toe right there. And it kind of reminded me of like watching Jimmy Connors and Chris Evert. They really went forward into their shot and they had that dragging of the toe. And a lot of times when you watch Federer, especially on practice court, he's gonna dramatically hold that toe back there when he's done. Okay, so That's everything you need to learn to start cloning the Federer back. And what you want to do is you want to come on out here and you just want to do some sets of shadow swings. Again, whether you're in your living room, whether you're on the court, and you can use a Topspin Pro, you can use a towel, right, and just maybe even put a ball on the towel so you can kind of see the ball and focus on swinging through it. And if you can video yourself and study yourself, now's the best time. There's no excuse to say, well, I've got to run off to a match, I don't have time to do that. It's the perfect time to actually video yourself and go, what am I doing step by step? I'm going to go back and I'm going to watch this video and go, how close am I to cloning Roger Federer's backhand? I know I'm not Roger Federer. I know I don't have near as good a backhand. I know it doesn't look as good as Roger's does, but I'm trying to learn and study and put as much of to that into my stroke as I can, right? So again, here's one more time what we're gonna focus on. We're focusing on a nice boxer shuffle. You wanna be loose and pretend you're Federer, you're light and airy. He plays like he doesn't have a care in the world. You wanna feel like that, feeling loose and relaxed. Notice how the racket is pointing to the backhand side and it's up. The hand is down here low, okay? You're gonna see that ball. You're gonna start to get really put your weight on this outside leg, super, super important. Putting the weight on the outside leg. The racket continues to rise up. As you come back, it comes a little higher. Then you gotta drop it in the slot, come up under the ball with a healthy step, and you gotta do your counterbalance. So all together, it looks something like this. Okay, and you just keep practicing that until it feels really great. And Roger Federer, it tends to be a nice steady loop. Once he's doing it, it's like a nice steady loop rhythm, and he's taking all his momentum and putting it into the tennis ball. Okay, so there's your day one, cloning Roger Federer's backhand. We're gonna have a lot more great stuff that we're gonna be doing, lots of drills. Tomorrow, it's gonna be all about how you can get even extra power and spin on your backhand. We're gonna be recapping a lot of what we did today, but we're gonna be adding more drills and exercises you could do to start to really feel the spin of the ball coming off. And we'll see you on the next video. If you like this Topspin Pro, I'm gonna put a link right beside the video too so you can grab yourself one, because I think it's a no-brainer to get, so you can really, no matter where you are, whether you bring it to the court, whether you're in your driveway, whether you're in your living room, you can kind of do the strokes and practice. You know, you can even practice running on out to a ball and then coming in and doing it and recovering and getting back, and running on out to a ball and hitting and pretending that you are playing a match against somebody. It's also a great way to get a workout. So remember, all you gotta do for day one is you gotta let me know what you're looking most forward to learning. You know, you can let me know what you thought about this video, and you can send in a video, whatever you do. If you're responding in some way, you're being entered into a raffle to win one of these Grip Right trainers. We're gonna hold it up for 48 hours. And I'm gonna send you Roger Federer's book too, so you can read from Mr. Perfect, Mr. Wonderful. And it's gonna be a great time. This is gonna be a great week. And I appreciate you guys really keeping a great attitude and really focusing on getting better, even in bad situations. And that's super, super important. That's gonna take you so far beyond the court. And so you're doing a great thing. This is actually gonna make you a better tennis player as well. So we're becoming better together. And thank you so much for watching day one of our 7-day Upgrade Your Backhand Challenge.